Hello, I'm back for round two. I will be on the draw, and this hand is bad enough to mulligan. This hand's good. Quite good, in fact. Looks like we're playing against Amulet of Vigor. Actually, it could be multiple combo decks. It could be Ad Nauseam combo as well. But if my opponent is playing Amulet, I've wanted to do this for quite a while. Once they put a Karu into play, I can Flickerwisp it, and that should be fun. Alright, there's a Karu right there. So next turn my opponent's going to have 6 mana, and that could just be the end of me. But if I get to survive one more turn, then I can Company the Karu, and that would be quite good. Yeah, really not much I can do. Just cast the Finx. This is probably not the best matchup game one, and my opponent had a pretty good draw. Just very fast, consistent, turn three Titan. Talaria West back to the hand. Okay, I did draw Path to Exile, so that's something. And then, I think I'm going to wait until the upkeep to Path, because right now my opponent has 8 mana. So if I Path, then my opponent will guaranteed have 9 mana. I don't want that. Oh, actually my opponent might not have a second forest. And then I just missed damage. Yeah. If I noticed that the forest was in play, maybe I would have gone for it. Okay, my opponent just naturally had a summoner's pack. Didn't need to even cycle the Talaria West. Okay, there's a Slayer's Stronghold. And Haste. Alright. Well, at this point, I sort of wish that I left up the Dromoka's command so I could fight the Titan. At this point, Flickerwisping a land is not going to be enough. It's really only enough when my opponent only has one or two lands in play. I think I'll block with Voice to make a bigger creature. If my opponent blocks, then I will put a counter on my Kitchen Finks and fight. Alright, my opponent did not block. Okay, my opponent's going to cycle Tolera West probably for... probably for Pact of Negation, so I'm going to respond. Hope that I hit Flickerwisp and get to flicker my opponent's Titan. Not really a long-term plan. But, yeah, one of them will flicker the Titan, and one of them will flicker the other Flickerwisp. So I get another Flickerwisp trigger at the end of turn. The problem is my opponent probably has, like, Radiant Fountain and Colony Garden. But I guess there's a small chance that I actually win this game. It's unfortunate that I missed 3 damage with the Finks earlier, because I didn't realize my opponent had his or her only forest, only basic land in play. I think if my opponent was at 11, I would actually be a favorite. Flickerwisp is pretty powerful in games like this. In round 1, we saw how weak it can be. Okay, my opponent did get Pact of Negation. Alright, I'm going to return the Primeval Titan first, see what my opponent gets. Hopefully I draw Path to Exile. Yeah, my opponent did get Radiant Fountain and Colony Garden, as expected. Wow. Because the fountain gains 2 life, it's not enough. Even if I draw a land, if I draw a Path to Exile, then I'll path, my opponent will counter, and then I'll cast Dromoka's Command, and I'll have 6, 12, 15 power, and my opponent will be at 16. I'm probably not going to die to the Primeval Titan. I don't really want my opponent to get more triggers. So I could just blink the plant. Or I could blink my Flickerwisp. Let's see, if I blink my other Flickerwisp, then I'll get to attack for 3. In my end step, it'll come back. I'll blink the Titan, and my opponent will miss another attack. Be at 13. And then I'll basically have the same setup once again. So it's pretty sweet. It's like a never-ending loop that my opponent can't counter. Alright, no need for that land. I'll just attack for 3. And this way, I'm in no danger of dying to the Slayer Stronghold and Sun Home put together. I guess it is ending at some point. Because, yeah, it's going to end on this turn, because I'm not flickering my Flickerwisp again. But I can maybe bait a counterspell from the Dromoka's Command, and then get the Collected Company to resolve, or maybe the opposite order. Okay, Seer and Visions. It would be pretty impressive if I won this game. My opponent just had turn 3 Titan. Pretty functional hand, and 2 backup Titans. I'm just playing a stupid green-white creature deck. Okay, Summer Bloom. probably going to gain a bunch more life from Radiant Fountain. To 15. My opponent probably has Vesuva, and it's going to gain even more life. Medium annoying. Let's see what my opponent gets off of Primeval Titan. I know that my opponent has Pact of Negation in hand. My opponent got a Rot Farm and another Teleria West. Okay. So what would I rather resolve? Tremoka's Command? Alright, I'm going to cast the Tremoka's Command and hope that my opponent counters it. I think the Collect Company is more powerful. If I hit Eternal Witness or another Flickerwisp, it's going to be very powerful. If I can Company for Witness, then I can get Path to Exile. Oh wow, my opponent had Slaughter Pact. That's annoying. So my opponent still has Pact of Negation. So next turn paying for Slaughter Pact and Pact of Negation will still leave my opponent enough mana to activate Stronghold and Sun Home. Pretty annoying. But I'm not actually going to die to that. That's 16 power. So I just need to put some toughness on it or have a Kitchen Finks. I'll just cast the Kitchen Finks, I think. That'll put me to 17. I'll attack for 6. Very good for my opponent to have the Slaughter Pact in hand. I think I could have beaten just Pact of Negation. I guess I might lose if there's two Primeval Titans and I have to guess which one gets Double Strike. Yeah, maybe I should have played the Company and forced my opponent into casting Pact. That probably would have been best. Because the creature gets first strike, my Finks are going to persist, so I'm not going to die this turn, I don't think. Yeah, I'm not going to die this turn. But I do have to block. Yeah, I have to block the bigger one, otherwise I die. Yeah, I definitely should have cast Collect Company on my turn to force Pact Negation, then my opponent wouldn't have exactly enough mana to do all of this. But then that would still require drawing something on my next turn to win. See, my opponent's at 13. And I have 10 power. Yeah, not quite enough. Well, I'm hopeful for the next game. I have Magus, Meddling Mage, and Unified Will. So I think I'll be advantaged post-board. Alright, I'll just concede. I can't win this game. Alright, I have a lot of good cards, I think. Unified Will, Meddling Mage, Magus, Aven Mind Sensor. I'll board in Reclamation Sage. They have Amulet and Hive Mind. Take out Command, Voice, Sphinx. Take out a Township. Flickerwisp is pretty essential. Can't take that out. I think I want the mana creatures. I want to be fast. So I'll take out an Eternal Witness as the last card. I also want to keep all my Path to Exiles. So I'll be back for game two. Hey, I'm back for game two on the play. This hand's really bad, but I'm going to keep. Yeah, really bad hand. Alright, at least my opponent had nothing to start. It's a good sign. Alright, Noble Hierarch's not a bad draw. My mana's really intense in the games where I have Magus in my deck. Because I have double green, double white, blue, and red. So I'm basically going to have to make a choice at some point. I was hoping my opponent would play Karoo that turn and I could Flickerwisp it. But that's fine. I'm not going to fetch right now because my life total is not that relevant and the thinning's not that relevant, so I just want more information. Flickerwisp, good draw. Let's see. Yeah, at any point I can cast the company to try to hit Flickerwisp or Magus or even Meddling Mage. But I'll let this resolve. I'll let that resolve. I'll let that resolve. Okay, all that is fine. Gonna fetch a basic planes, I think. Yep. And then cast the company. Alright, I'll get Noble Hierarch and Magus. Magus should be enough to just end my opponent. I'll flicker a land. Alright, I should have flickered my planes. I thought that it might still trigger, but obviously it doesn't with Magus in play. I'll attack with just the Flickerwisp. So that's 5. Next turn's also 5. If I play the Flickerwisp, that's 8. Okay, I'll add one more threat to the board. Really bad if my opponent has something like Pyroclasm. Alright, I'll keep the Geist in hand for sure. Alright, Magus was very good that game. Now that my opponent knows about it, my opponent's definitely going to board in removal of some kind. Problem is, I don't really know what. If I have Meddling Mage, I'll probably name Slaughter Pact, but who knows, my opponent might have Pyroclasm. Let's see. I like Geist just because of the fast clock it provides. I could cut Eternal Witness. It's not really a grindy game. I'm just looking to end the game. On the draw, I probably don't need the extra land of Township. I think I'm going to cut a witness just to have one more cheap creature. I want cheap creature to be aggressive, and so that my unified wills are turned on when I want them to be. So it'll be a scavenging use, I think. Alright, I'll be back for game 3. Hello, I'm here for game 3 on the draw, and I am going to keep this hand. This is the type of hand that, I don't know, some people might mulligan, but that really is not my style. I love hands that just have all mana creatures and you have to draw something good. If my opponent plays a Karu this turn, the Flickerwisp is going to be so good. I'm just begging for it to happen. Alright, that did not happen. I guess I'll play another Hierarch and attack. And then I'll play Avacyn's Pilgrim. It's possible my opponent played around Flickerwisp with the Golgari Rot Farm. If so, that was a very good play. I really hope I draw some interactive spell. I have a decent number in my deck at this point. Oh, wow. It's unfortunate my opponent doesn't have two Karus, otherwise I would really do something. It really doesn't even do much to flicker a Karu at this point in the game. It would have been very devastating early. Alright, so now I have a choice. I can either attack for 3 with the Pilgrim, or flicker my Flickerwisp. Alright, I'm gonna attack for 3 and play my bird. Based on the way my opponent played, it seemed like there's a Pact of Negation, or maybe a Hive Mind kill coming. So I want to get the bird out there, I think. I did sort of also just gain my opponent 2 life by boomeranging the land. Unified Will would be a great draw, or Collected Company. If I hadn't boarded out Township for this Stomping Ground, I would have a Township, and at least have pressure, but I think I'm just going to lose no matter what. Alright, this is a little bit disheartening. Alright, I'm gonna flicker my flicker and then exile my opponent's Primeval Titan. This deck has pretty high variance, I guess. When you draw a Collected Company, it seems very powerful. And then a lot of times, I just get a draw with all mana creatures. Okay, here's a Summer Bloom. My opponent still has a Talaria West in hand. Alright, that's going to kill a lot of my creatures, but they don't really matter. Okay, my opponent has another Talaria West. Well, I get to hit my opponent down to 10 and then play another Flickerwisp. So my opponent can maybe only gain 2 life, and then if I draw a Gavinny Township, maybe I can win. Nope, my opponent's Slaughter Pact. Yeah, that'll probably be the end of me. Yeah, once the Primeval Titan chain starts going, it's pretty unending. I'll be back for round 3. I can't win this game.